Among the many logical functions, one that is commonly used is switch. Switch defines the result depending on the first argument that needs to be an expression. Switch evaluates the first argument and then it starts inspecting the next arguments. The next arguments come in pair. There's always a value and a result. Switch checks the first argument with the first of the pairs, and if there is a match, then it returns the corresponding value. The process goes on until it finishes evaluating all the possibilities. Let's see that with an example. In this measure, discounted sales, I want to compute the sales where the discount percentage depends on the category. So it iterates over each category, and for each category, it computes the discount percentage. That uses switch. Switch evaluates its first argument, product category, and then it compares product category with the first, audio. If category is equal to audio, then the result is 0.15, that is 15%. If not, then it goes on the next one and checks if category is equal to computers. In that case, it returns 20%. The process goes on through all the values which are listed inside switch. Switch also accepts the last argument which appears alone, that is the default value. If none of the option is valid, then switch returns the default value. If you do not provide anything, the default value is considered to be blank. Internally, switch is converted into a set of nested if statements. It evaluates the first expression and then it checks if it is equal to the first of the pairs, then it returns the corresponding value. Otherwise, it goes with the second pair and repeats the process for each of the pairs you provided. A somewhat creative usage of switch is quite common, and it is to switch on a constant value. Let's see an example. Here, I am computing again the discount percentage, but this time I'm not using the category, I'm using different conditions. I want to compare the net price less than 150, or the net price less than 1,000, or the category being audio. So I'm using different columns and I'm using different conditions. I'm not providing a list of values, instead I'm providing a list of conditions. I can use switch in such a scenario if I switch on true. Switching on true, I'm switching on a constant value, it's always true. But what switch will do, it evaluates this condition. If this equals to true, then it returns 15%. Otherwise, it goes on the next line and it checks that this condition is true. If it is true, then it returns the corresponding value. Otherwise, it goes on the next one. So by switching over true, you can provide a list of conditions, and the first one that matches true defines the result of switch. One thing you need to pay attention to is the order in which you provide the list of options. Because remember, switch is converted into a set of nested if statements. This means that the first condition that is met defines the result. This is the same code we saw earlier, I just changed the order of the first two lines. Less than 1000 appears before less than 150. This means that if a net price is less than 150, it is also less than 1000. Therefore, the first condition is less restrictive than the second one. Any row that satisfies the second condition also satisfies the first one. So, basically, the second condition will never met, and you will never obtain 15% out of this switch. The order of the arguments is important, and you need to pay attention to that if you want to avoid wrong results.